Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to take you through 10 apps that I think are super awesome and super valuable for me on my Mac. Some of them you may have heard of, some of them you may not have, but I'm going to spend less than a minute on each one. I'm going to try it to at least, so we can rapid fire through these apps and you can see hopefully something that's new and useful that you might enjoy. Let's jump into it.
Okay, so we're going to start with an app called Cleft. Cleft is in early access right now. It's available on TestFlight for iOS, and you can just download it for the Mac. In terms of pricing, it's completely free right now, but it will cost $30 a year if you have your own OpenAI key, or if you want to use what we're going to show here, it's going to be $5 a month. So whether it'll be worth it, I don't know, but it's really cool. So here's a transcript that I have. So the concept of the app is that you record into it, or you give it a file, and you just start talking, or you record a meeting, or something like that. And what it'll do is make a transcript of it. It's using OpenAI's Whisper transcription model, so it's very high quality. It's going to capture everything, but that's just a blob of text. So what do? Well, it will convert it into notes for you, which is really awesome. So this is kind of a meta one where I was talking about Cleft Notes and what I like about it. And so it's converting this into, here are the things you talked about in this big wall of text. There's a couple apps that try to do this. Cleft Notes is the best one I found myself. Next up is Multiviewer, which lets you watch all sorts of racing series in a special UI. It's completely free, and let's just take a look at it. As I'm recording this, the Chinese Grand Prix is going on, and sprint qualifying has already happened. So let me watch the replay. This is going to be tied to my personal F1 TV account. But what's cool about here, as you may interpret from the name, is I can choose to see live replay timing. I want to see the international feed. And I want to see Lewis Hamilton's onboard. And I can open these selected views, and it's going to open these three. And I can go ahead and resize these, but now I can see the live timings over here. I can see Hamilton right here. I can see the broadcast here. And when you're watching live, you can they'll all be synced up and everything. But for example, there we go. I've got the feed going here. I'm going to probably blur this out for copyright issues, but yeah, I can watch in whatever combination I want. I can see the onboards for whatever I want. It's super powerful. I can do way more windows than this, but this app is awesome. Next up is Solver. Solver is a notepad plus a calculator, and it's pretty interesting. It's useful for me in very specific situations. So yesterday I was doing some conversions of power amounts, 1.3 terawatt hours. I want to know how much bigger that was than 180 million kilowatt hours. And it's able to do that. Anyway, all sorts of math here. You can also do something like 6 foot, 10 inches in meters. And that's going to give you the answer over there on the right. I could also do things like, what's the current Apple stock price? There it is. What's Microsoft's stock price? There it is. Let's say I have 100 Apple pieces of stock, or plus 30 Microsoft, that's worth $28,590.90. There's lots of use cases for this. These are just basic examples, but this is the sort of thing that Solver lets you do. Then we have Keyboard Maestro, which is an app that I adore. I use it for a ton of things like text expansion, but it also lets you record macros that are very specific to what your particular needs might be. So I'm currently using a macro that I've created to bulk delete things from my Readwise account. And it's just going through, my hands are totally off the keyboard right now, but it's going through, it's clicking specific buttons to remove these items. There's no way to do this in Readwise's interface, but I was able to use Keyboard Maestro to create a way to do this myself automatically. It's going to remove 50 and then stop on its own. This is awesome. I made a whole other video about how you can use Keyboard Maestro, so check that out in the description. Then we have, not Puzmo, although Puzmo is an awesome little website. I'll put a link in the description. Next up, we have SuperCopy. So one of my favorite features in Arc is the ability to hit Command-Shift-C to copy the current URL to the clipboard very quickly. It's quick. It's awesome. I adore it. But that's not in Safari. So if you want to get that functionality in Safari, there's an extension called SuperCopy, where if I hit the same keyboard shortcut, I paste this, it's going to paste that URL. So there's no UI. It would be nice if it popped something up to let you know that it worked, but that adds the shortcut to Safari, and I love it. Then we have Audio Hijack, which is a way to record audio from your Mac. You can do a ton of different recordings. You can record your computer audio. You can record from microphones. You can do all sorts of workflows. You see the sort of workflow that they've got here. I'll show you a very basic one that I have set up for myself. So I have this workflow called Record Shure Microphone. And basically, it lets me talk into this microphone. I'm going to start the recording now. It goes through a transcribe step. So it's going to create a text file with a transcription of everything I say in this. and it's recording an audio file. And you can kind of see, if I click into one, there's the settings for each. You can see it's transcribing, where I can customize how the transcription looks, the name of the file, and then what it's outputting. And you can, again, see a lot of customization here. So I'm going to go ahead and hit stop on this. And if I go to my downloads folder, I have an audio file and I have this text file with the transcription of everything I said. And that transcription can be useful, again, feed it into other tools to create a nice outline, all that good stuff. Also from the same company is an app called Fission. Fission is an audio editing tool, but I use it to convert audio files. So one of the things that I find myself kind of often having to do is to create MP3 files of files that aren't MP3s. And so with Fission, you can go ahead and drag in, this is an M4A file, drag it in here. You can also do this with the video files and everything. We'll hit export, and you can choose from these file formats, an MP3, let's export it to downloads. And it's very quick, very nice, super simple app, actually a pretty powerful app, but I use it for a very simple thing, and I think it's really nice. Next up, we have MacWhisper, which is available here on Gumroad. There's a free version, there's a pro version. I use the pro version because I use it so much, it's totally worth it to me. But basically, this is the app, and you can drag in an audio file, a video file, you can record directly into it, whatever, and you can create high-quality transcripts for these files for you. And so this is actually an audio track from a video that is either up right now or will be up shortly, but it's creating a transcription for me. It'll be done here in a second. There we go. And I can export this as a subtitles file. This is what I do for all the videos here on a better computer, because I think it makes a better subtitle file than what YouTube automatically generates. But you can export it as all sorts of different things, different file types. Really awesome. Again, totally free to use if you want, but you can also pay £29 in whatever your currency is, which we could use Solver to find that. Actually, Solver, we'll do 29 British pounds in USD is 3606. So yeah, again, one of those little things where Solver is just nice to have around, but we're not talking about Solver. We're moving on to the next app. Getting close to the end now, we've got an app here called BentoCraft. And BentoCraft lets you make those kind of cool diagrams that Apple has made popular on their kind of presentations. But you can do all sorts of different sizes and everything. If we pull in an image, that should go right up there. If you want to pull in phone screenshots, those can go in even. And yeah, just kind of pick the one that you need. Let's go ahead and do this one and then pull this file in there. You can click into these and change the name. There we go. And again, change the colors. There's some stuff here that you can do, some settings, but we don't have time to get into that. Basically, a quick way, it's a free app with some optional in-app purchases, but you can make some really nice visuals here with BentoCraft. And finally, we're going to end with Ollama, which is a way to basically run language models on your computer locally. So I could turn off my Wi-Fi, don't need the internet, and there are all sorts of models I can use. Right, so Llama 3, Gemma, which is kind of the open source version of Gemini. But yeah, so you can kind of use these things. You can install them, run them, all that good stuff. I have Gemma running here. Tell me about a standard F1 weekend. And so it's just doing the kind of normal thing that you would get from any of these large language models. It's going to create an answer for you. I do find these are not as good as the online ones, but they can be useful. And if you want to use something totally local, this is a good way to play around with that. Tell me how this differs from Formula E. And so, yeah, it's just going to do all the things running totally locally on your machine. And yeah, cool thing to play around with. So that's it. That's 10 apps on the Mac that I think are really cool. Hopefully one or two of them was useful to you, and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.